Hello, it's me James, and welcome back to another Minecraft Bedrock Edition tutorial. So in today's video, we've got a brand new way of AFK fishing. I say a new way because some of the techniques I'm going to show you on this AFK fish farm, I've never seen before, and I'm pretty sure you guys have never seen them before. That being said, I've got two massive shout-outs, the first one being Only21. This guy clearly came up with some of these techniques. Again, they are so good to make this as efficient as it is. And the other one is Craft Artist. This guy basically made it a multiple person fish farm, not only just a one person, so on Realms you can use it for multiple use. He also took a lot of the design and shrunk it down a little bit and made it a lot smaller. So a massive shout out to both of those. Their links are in the description. Also, if you're interested in joining a free subscriber realm, my link to the Discord is in the description. And that's where you can find the invite to the free subscriber realm. Again, if you have not got Discord, do not fear. You can always add me on the Twitter or on Instagram, and that way I can just send you the invite code there. So that being said, let's get straight on to this video. I'm super hyped for this one, guys. Again, some of these techniques I've never ever seen before, so let me show you exactly what you're gonna need. Okay, so the items required to build this farm are as follows. You're gonna need 3 trap doors, you're gonna need 1 bucket of water, 1 bucket of water and cod, 1 stone step, any step will do, 1 stone slab, again any slab will do, 4 signs, 3 chests, 1 rail, you're going to need a minecart with a hopper inside it, you're going to need a bucket of lava, 2 concrete blocks, again they don't need to be concrete blocks, just solid blocks, a hopper, and also 7 pieces of glass. Okay, so step 1, simply all you're going to want to do is grab your hoppers and your chests, not the rails just yet. Grab your chests, and you're going to obviously find a location on where you want your fish farm. Simply place your chest down. We're just going to place it here. Crouch space and place the hopper into the back. That is step 1 complete. Okay, step 2, all you're going to want to do is grab your glass, and we're going to simply block in that hopper, because this is where your lava is going to go on top. Also, this is where your hopper minecart is going to sit. So you just want to follow exactly what I do, block around your hopper. Again, you only need 3 bits, but you're going to need some holder blocks. You can remove any unnecessary blocks. Go and place a block on the back of that as well. Okay, so now you're ready for step 3. So now we're going to need a few of the signs that we got together. So we're just going to grab those. We're going to put 1 on this block, just like so. We're then going to grab some glass again, just to use as a holder block, and place a sign just up from that one just here. What this is going to do is keep your lava in place. So, step 4, what we can do now is actually get our hopper minecart in the position. You can also place a piece of glass just there. I forgot about that earlier. So, basically, you're going to want your hopper minecart to go in where that hopper is. If you can't get it facing the right way, you will need 2 pieces, and then just put them next to each other, and then you're free to delete those. Again, get your hopper minecart, place it on top, and just push that inside, just like so. So now we're pretty much ready to put the lava in. Again, you are obviously going to need to remove this rail. You don't need that rail there anymore. So what we can do is just remove the rail, and we can also put ourselves another block on top of that piece of glass. And that is literally all the glass you're going to need. Okay, so now all you want to do is grab your lava, and we can simply place it above the hopper minecart, just like that. Again, the lava is super important for this. What the lava actually does is when you cast the rod in and catch something, this automatically, okay, automatically takes off what you've caught, and it doesn't destroy the item at all. It goes straight into that hopper minecart and straight into the chest. Again, this is a nice little technique which I've never seen before. A lot more people should be using this technique as well, hence why I'm doing this video. Alright, so right now you want to grab your solid blocks. Again, these do not need to be red concrete, they can be any solid blocks that you want. I wouldn't pick wood though, obviously, because you're near to lava. So you want to place them in those positions exactly like I have. Then we're going to grab our chest and place it on the nearest block towards the lava. Super easy, super simple. Then we're going to want to grab a holder block. It doesn't matter what block. Again, this one's going to get destroyed. And we're going to place it, not there, we're going to place it behind the chest. And this is how we're going to get our trapdoors all closed behind it. So then you obviously want to grab your trap doors. Again, you can literally use any trap doors that you want. I'm just using spruce wood because I absolutely love spruce wood. And what we're doing here is just placing them all around this holder block. Again, we're going to destroy the middle block. And what this is going to do, this is where we're going to put our cod in a bucket, okay? So the cod in the bucket goes at the back and the normal water will go in the chest. We're going to obviously flood the chest. But first, we need to add some signs around the chest so we don't have any spillage whatsoever. So we'll just put some signs on. Again, you don't have to put YY. I have no idea why I put YY. You don't have to write on the signs. But now we're pretty much there. Again, you don't need to block the top of the chest for the way that you fish in this farm, and I'll show you that at the end. So now obviously just grab any other items that you've got in your chest because we're pretty much there. So again, grab your step, your half slab, your cod in a bucket, and also your normal water. So with the normal water bucket, we're going to flood the chest, like I said. So you're probably going to want to crouch space somewhere. And for example, just on this little piece of glass here, we're just going to go down. You're not going to be able to do it from the top because it's going to keep opening. If you can't reach it, there we go, and just put it at the bottom, and we flooded the chest. And then you want to put your cod in a bucket at the back. Trust me when I say I have no idea how the cod in the bucket works, but I'm telling you now, this makes it so much more efficient. Now we're going to be on our final step, and basically we're just going to be placing a stone step. So place the stone step just there and a half slab at this height, right above the step. All that half slab's going to do is when you're actually fishing in this farm, you're never going to be able to fall in the lava, which is super important. If you go AFK or you knock your controller or something like that, and you fall in the lava, you're not going to like it very much. So let me just show you exactly how to get this thing working. You're just going to want to aim at the sign straight away, not the top of the chest, straight to the sign. And this thing is so efficient. Again, you do not have to recast when you catch an item. It's going to do that fully automatically for you. So this is definitely the best way to go if you're on Xbox or a PS4 or something like that. However, like Windows 10 and stuff like that, you can get this fully automatic by simply downloading a simple auto clicker. Again, I can put one of those in the link in the description. That is not a problem. But for me, this is way, way, way more powerful than I ever expected it to be. And again, this is actually good enough. All you've got to do is sit there and press the recast it. You do not have to catch the items. It's just one click, whereas before you'd have to do like two clicks on a farm. However, this one is fully collecting your items automatically. That is the most important thing about this farm. For you, like I said, for you guys on Xbox and PS4, this is definitely the way to go. And as you can see already, we've actually got a fair few items. Like, we've been going how long? A minute or something? Maybe less than a minute. And let me just show you exactly how many items we've actually got. So let's just have a brief look. We got 8 fish, we got a few more different fish, we got a bow, we got a book. See what I mean? This thing is crazy, crazy fast. It's just so good. So that is literally the end of the tutorial. Basically, I'm still pretty shocked at how good this farm actually is. As far as the lava technique and the cod in the bucket technique, me personally, I've never ever seen those techniques before. A massive shout out to Only21. Again, Craft Artist did make this a multi-person farm as well, and he obviously shrunk it down because obviously Only21's design had a load of observers and stuff that we really didn't need. Craft Artist did a lot of work here, so he's also in the description as well. A massive, massive shout out to both of you guys. As the cod in a bucket goes, I literally still can't get over that. The cod in the bucket is one of the things, like I say, that makes the efficiency of this farm super amazing. I still do not know at all how it works, but I assure you it does work. If you just put normal water in this and try it, it won't be as efficient as if you put a cod in the bucket in it. How crazy is that? So that is literally the end of the video. I do hope you have enjoyed it. Again, if you do want to join a free subscriber round, feel free to hit me up on the Discord and you'll find the invite code there. If you do not have Discord, feel free to add me on either Twitter or Instagram, and again, I'll be happy to send you the invite code on any of those as well. So if any of you guys watching this video have got any tutorials that you think needs to be seen, again, feel free to hit me up on any of the social medias and I will try and put that into production, give you credit for the video. That will be super, super epic. One last thing, I do really, really, really want to hit 10k this year. I'm not sure if we can do it. I mean, my target was to get 6k, but I've got a really good feeling that we might actually do it. So if you would, please, please, please subscribe with that notification bell on, and I would appreciate that so much. I mean, 10k is a big ask, but I really got the belief that we can actually do this, you know. I've seen some amazing growth this year. I want to say a massive thank you to everybody who's been supporting my channel, and everyone who's been here from day one. So, that is literally the end. No more talking. I will catch you on the next one.